Atrial fibrillation is a very common abnormal rhythm. A lot of the patients that I see wonder if this is something that they did to cause an abnormal rhythm, and it's not. It's usually very predominant in patients, and predominantly in patients over 70 years of age. It can be up to 20% of people who have this. And so usually when someone comes in and they're of that age group, I tell them, if you ask a few of your friends, you're going to find some compatriots in this disease. Nobody is quite sure exactly why patients develop atrial fibrillation, and that's where a lot of cardiac electrophysiology research goes towards. A common thing for patients to complain of are a sensation of an abnormality in their heart, a flip-flopping, or the sensation that their heart is fluttering. And a common question is, well, should I go and see my doctor for that? It's not chest pain, I'm not short of breath, but I felt something in there. And I tell them, absolutely yes. Usually that sensation is what we call a palpitation. And a palpitation usually suggests, or may suggest, an abnormal heart rhythm. It can be a slow heart rhythm, which we call bradycardia. It could be a fast heart rhythm, which we call tachycardia. And those are all abnormalities that need to be evaluated because they can lead to further concerns. It's interesting, as we talked about atrial fibrillation and it being very common in patients who are older, doesn't necessarily mean that patients who are younger don't have atrial fibrillation, but it's much more common for them to have another abnormal rhythm. And so when younger patients come in and tell me that they have an abnormal rhythm that's similar to their grandfather's, it's usually not the same abnormal rhythm, but it's still something that needs to be evaluated.